Hi guys, welcome back to Calm Your Cat, it's Claire and Rags, and this week we're going to be talking about taking your cat out with you. Now before we start, let me know in the comment section below if you take your cat out on adventures. Where do you go? Do you go up mountains? Do you go kayaking? Or do you just walk down the street? Let me know in the comment section below. Taking cats out on adventures is becoming more and more popular. You just need to go on any social media platform to see there are loads of cats out there who go on adventures with their humans. But which is the best way to do this? Is it better to take them out on a leash or in a carrier? Well, this week Rex and I are going to talk to you about the pros and cons of both so that you can make that decision and see what is best for your cat. I'm going to start with talking about carriers. Now, I don't mean the carriers that you take your cat for the vet in, but I'm talking about the ones, they're kind of like backpacks or suitcases that you can put your cat in so they can see out and see the world when you're taking them out and about with you. Rex actually does have a backpack carrier. I take her in it to the vets because I usually cycle to the vets. It's only down the road from here. So it's much easier for her to be on my back. And that is one of the pros of taking your cat out with you in a carrier. It is hands-free, so you've got your cat on your back and you are free to do your hands whatever you want. Especially if you're up climbing somewhere or you're kayaking or doing something with your hands, having your cat on your back is a lot more easier for you and your cat. Carriers also protect your cat from the elements, so if there is a rogue storm or it starts raining or snowing, knowing that your cat is out with you but also nice and snug in this carrier is a real plus. It can also protect them from any unexpected dangers, so like other animals, dogs, other cats maybe, or any sort of wildlife that you come across while you're out and about. Carriers are also great because your cat can go for a snooze while you're in there. If you're on a long walk or you're out somewhere for a while and your cat might get tired, they can just curl up and go for a nice sleep while they're being carried by you. So what are some cons of the carriers? Well, one thing is that you're not always going to have an eye on your cat. So if your cat gets distressed or something, you just don't know, you can't see them right from where you are. Also, if it's a particularly hot day or the sun is really bearing down, you don't know if your cat is going to be overheating in the back. In most cases, these bags do actually have ventilation in them, but if it's a really, really hot day, you don't know if your cat is going to get overheated or uncomfortable in that bag. Also, if you slip and fall on your back, you're going to be landing on the bag with your cat in it. Now, most of these bags are very sturdy, obviously, but it's not going to be very nice for your cat. It might be quite distressing and a little bit painful if you do fall onto the bag which your cat is in. Also, if your cat is in a carrier, you don't know when they're going to need to go to the toilet, and they might go to the toilet in the bag, which is unpleasant for everybody involved. So what about leashes? Now, leash training your cat is something you should do at a younger age, but we're not going to go into that in this vlog. We're going to talk about the pros and cons of taking your cat out with you on a leash. The first is that they get to experience the adventure firsthand. They are not confined to a bag or a carrier and can wander around sniffing and smelling and experiencing all the things that you're doing, which is great that you can share that adventure with them in that way. The next is that they can go to the toilet whenever they need to. They don't need to do it in the bag, like I said before. They can just sort of take themselves off, obviously on the leash, and go for the toilet wherever they need to be. So they're not going to get caught short. The next is you get to keep an eye on your cat. You have them in front of you or to the side of you, and you can see them. So if they get distressed or get upset or anything, you get to see exactly where they are and not have to wonder how they're doing in the bag. And finally, this might seem a bit vain, but it's great for photo ops or to videos for your social media. Like if you want to make a TikTok about your cat or an Instagram post and they're looking really, really cute on a mountaintop, that is just, well, perfect really. But what are some cons about taking your cat out on a leash? Well, the first one is that they're not protected from anything that might come along that might be a bit scary or a threat to them. So maybe other animals or the cats, dogs, that kind of thing. They are out in the elements, and if something it was to sneak up or surprise the two of you, your cat is quite vulnerable. The next is that you don't have your hands free. You're holding onto the leash for your cat, which, you know, isn't the biggest inconvenience, but can be if you are like climbing or hiking and you need to both your hands. The next is that they are a little bit more exposed, so to the elements, or they might, if you're kayaking with them or canoeing, they might fall into the water. So if you are going to take your cat out on a leash, obviously try and take them somewhere that isn't too risky for them. So that's a discussion about taking your cat out and about with you on adventures, whether you should do it with a carrier or a leash, and basically it is up to the cat. Some cats might not really like being on a leash and some might not like being in a bag. It's up to your cat, I'm afraid. So like I said before, let me know in the comment section below if you take your cat on adventures. We really love to know whereabouts you go and what you get up to with your cat. If you did enjoy the video, guys, please give us a big thumbs up. It helps the channel out loads. And if you're not subscribed to Calm Your Cat already, all you need to do is hit the button in the middle of the screen there. And while you're at it, head on over to our vlog from last week, which is just on the other side of the screen, and give that a bit of love as well. Thanks again for watching, and Rags and I will see you in our next vlog. Bye!